Mukam karoti vachalam pangum nangayati girim yatra patam vande shri guru jena sarinam shri krishna chaitanya prabhu nityananda shri advaita shri gadadha shri vasari gaura bhakta vanda hare krishna
hare krishna 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 hare 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 rama hare rama
Jagat Guru Adi Guru Nityananda Mahaprabhu Ki
Jai!
Nityananda Mahaprabhu Ki
Jai!
We can do much better than that. Nityananda Mahaprabhu Ki
Jai!
Let me offer my humble obeisances to Lord Nityananda, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, whose opulence is wonderful and unlimited. By his will, even a fool like me can also understand and say something. Jai Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Jai Nityananda, Jai Advaita Chandra, Jai Gadadha, Jai Bhakta Vrinda.
Jai Jai.
You don't have to say it. Hare Krishna. So next 45 minutes, so my plan was, so first we'll talk about introduction, what I'm going to say. The next is we can talk about what is the content, and then summary, that's the take-home points, and then at the end we'll have some question answers if the time permits. So the topic, as we all know, today is Lord Nityananda Mahaprabhu's appearance day. So it's a two-part. The one is, who is Nityananda Mahaprabhu? To understand the little tattva, little technical, please bear with me. Without understanding the tattva or guru tattva, who is Nityananda Mahaprabhu, directly getting to the pastimes is sometimes esoteric and also it could be sentimental. Because we have to understand whenever we sing, whatever we do, we have to know the purpose of that, what is the objective of that, at least the meaning why we do. So that then we have a single focused, because we have the base. From the base we can understand. Otherwise, if there is no base, we can go anywhere. And then if you fall down, we can get lost. The topic is so huge. So please bear with me. The first is tattva. So you are all with me so far?
Yes.
Is any first timers today? I don't see anybody besides me. Okay. So who is Balaram? So Balaram and Krishna, there is no difference. But there is a little difference. There is a little difference. The difference is twofold. The one is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, is a master God. Supreme Personality of Godhead, Balaram, is a servant God. There is only one. For the purpose of pastimes, the purpose of to understand who is Krishna, only he has to tell us. If a great person wants to be revealing his greatness, a common person cannot understand. The great person has to say. So the Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. To show the world how great he manifests himself as Balaram to show how great he is. So that's the first difference. First is, one is Hare Krishna. So one is master God, the second is a servant God. We will get into the details. So second difference is the color. One is monsoon cloud, blackish blue, Krishna. The second is autumn or a spring cloud, which is white. That is only the difference between Krishna and Balaram. There is no other difference. And then, as we all know, there are five rasas, right? Neutrality, shantaras, dhasiras, sakhyaras, vatsalaras, and madhuriras. So Balaram is such a personality, he exhibit or he serve Krishna in all these five rasas. First is shantaras, meaning temple or dham, Krishna's shoes, Krishna's flute, Krishna's dress, anything which gives pleasure to Krishna, anything which can be used to serve Krishna. There is nothing beyond which we cannot use in Krishna's service. In other words, everything whatever you see, what you cannot see, what you pursue, what you don't pursue, everything is a manifestation of Balaram. For objectives was to serve Krishna. Because he is the best servant. So that service in the Santaras is exhibited by many things. That is Santaras. The second thing is Sakhyaras. Sorry, Dasaras, as a servant. As a servant is like Lakshman. And many times Krishna became a master and Balaram became his servant. Sometimes he served him in master-servant relationship with all endeavorance. The next is Sakhyaras, which is a friend. We all know the Krishna Balaram, and how Krishna is standing in Balaram. So Balaram facilitate that friendly relationship. Sometimes Krishna ask his opinions. Sometimes ask his feedback. Hey, what's things going on? What can I do? How can I do? What do you think? So, and the third is, fourth is the Vatsalaras. Sometimes Balaram becomes his older brother. Sometimes he acts like his mother. Sometimes he acts like his father. Sometimes Krishna rests on Balaram's lap when he's tired. Of course, Madhuraras, which is the highest of that. So, Radharani's sister, which is Ananga Manjari, is actually non-different than the expansion of Balaram. So, of course, in the Madhuraras, Krishna is only served by the feminine potency, which is the gopis. So, the male body is not allowed. That's how it is, because Madhurya means there is no Radharani or gopis will not get married in that mode. If you get the marriage, it's like a familiarity, breed contempt, you know, you all know that. So when the familiarity comes, so then there's a familiarity, there's actually that loving relationship or Madhurya that will be not be the very sweet. So that's the reason Balaram become Ananga Manjari. So who is actually none different, none other than the Radharani's sister in the spiritual world. So in other words, the Balaram is continuously 24/7, we will talk about that in a few minutes, is serving Krishna to give pleasure. This is the only objective. The best servant is Balaram. So that's Balaram. And then now, he knows how to serve. But now there's so many of us who wants to serve, but we don't know. To teach us, he takes the role of a guru. What is a guru's role? To teach the living entity or any soul how to serve Krishna. So, as a servant, he's also taking the leader, the servant leader. There's something very common in the corporate world now, the servant leader. Even though he's the master, he's a leader, but they're taking the role of a servant to teach to somebody to become better than that person. That is the mood of guru. The guru will never think, my disciple, we should only stay low so that I can teach him as much as he's a step below. No, the Balaram is so in the mood of to make us excel. Hey, he's better than me. That is the mood. Whoever the guru does that is a real guru. So he's Adi Guru. So that's the Balaram Tattva, the difference between Krishna and Balaram and the five types of rasas. Then now, let's go back. How does Balaram come into existence? Because in the spiritual world, there is no time. In the spiritual world, there is no time. Whenever in the material world, anything, it starts with time. And the progression is measured in terms of time. And the conclusion or the end is also measured with the time. So now if you go back to the few minutes for tattva perspective, if you understand the spiritual world. So Krishna expands into Balaram, as I said, right? So Balaram becomes the dham in the spiritual world. So there is so many types of dhams. The highest is Golok. There is actually three dhams is very highest in the spiritual world. The first is Golok, next is Dwaraka, third is Mathura, right? So all of dham is expansion of Balaram, right? So now, all Krishna does is, he just plays with his friends, plays the flute and enjoys. To facilitate that enjoyment is done by Balaram. So now, how does that happen? So Krishna has unlimited energies. So Balaram is a spiritual energy. People should not be confused between Balaram and Radharani. Same person, left side, you think about it, Balaram has a spiritual energy, internal spiritual energy. The right side, if I can think of, I'm just giving the side, you can pick whatever side you want. It's not technical, but I'm just giving a side, for analytical perspective. So Radharani is internal potency. For example, I'll just give an example, like for mundane way, so I like rice dal, so I just use the rice dal example, right? Somebody's laughing. So to make the rice dal happen, we need a field, which is on. Then now we need a seed, which is expansion of Balaram. We need water, we need a sun, we need air, we need a fire. Somehow it grows. When it grows, finally the product is rice at all. Then now what we do, we pick it up, we want to offer it to Krishna. So what we do, we bring it to temple. And how we bring it, that's also energy of Krishna, Balaram. And then eventually we start cooking, which is the fire, is expansion of Balaram. We'll explain in a few minutes. And eventually all the spices, vegetables, is everything is a manifestation of Balaram for purpose of serving Krishna. So finally, rice dal is ready. Now, rice dal is offered to Krishna. So who offers it? We offer to Guru, and Guru offers to his Guru. And finally, everybody eventually offered to Krishna, Radharani. So ultimately, Radharani serves Krishna, right? When Radharani offers the energy of Balaram, which is nothing but Krishna's energy, for his pleasure, the Krishna enjoy that rice dal. The enjoyment is done by Radharani's Haladini Shakti. Even though the Guru, or Guru Tattva, entire cosmic manifestation bring up to the stage where it is offered to Krishna, but Krishna enjoying, like when sometimes we eat some sabji or whatever preparation, there is no taste, there is no nutrition. So what happened, that the taste is actually Radharani. If we take the flower, to raise the flower, all this is watering, putting the seeds, all those things is energy of the Balaram. But ultimately, the fragrance of flower is Radharani. You understand? The fragrance is Radharani, which is now Krishna enjoys. So that is the difference between, I don't want to get into the too detail, technical. So you understand energy of Krishna, which is the Balaram, and the Haladini Shakti, which is the pleasure potency, is Radharani. You're all with me so far? So now, let's get into a little bit Tattva, one more Tattva, few more minutes I want to spend some time here. So, Balaram, as I said, is the first expansion of Krishna. And then now Balaram expands into first Chaturvyuha. There's the three types of Chaturvyuha expansion, there's the four of them. But the first expansion, Balaram into Vasudev, Sankarshan, Pradyumna, Aniruddha. Vasudev, Sankarshan, Pradyumna, Aniruddha. So now, from there, that first Chaturvyuha set, Sankarshan expands into Narayan. And Narayan again expands into second Chaturvyuha, which is again Mahavasudev, Mahasankarshan, Mahapradyumna, Mahaniruddha. You're all with me so far? So now, so far these two, Chaturvyuha is still stays in spiritual world. As a predominant deities, or the sides of Dham, is everything is done by these four. So the second set of Chaturvyuha, which where we have Mahasankarshan, expands into Mahavishnu. So still in spiritual world. This material world is not started yet. This is still happening in the spiritual world, right? So when the material world is necessary, because why? We are all part and parcel of Krishna. Objective of that is to serve Krishna. Now, an infinitesimal, a free will we have, we decided or chose not to serve Krishna. Why Krishna? Why not me? I am Krishna. I am the proprietor. I am the controller. I am the enjoyer. So now, how do we do that? The desire, everybody has a desire. The Balaram is so compassionate, he has to facilitate he does two facilitation. One is to facilitate Krishna's enjoyment, and to facilitate Jiva's so-called enjoyment to show that he is not Krishna. How? Facilitation has to happen. So that's the reason he created the material world. Then we come here, the Balaram is facilitating our desire. I wish I am like this. Okay, so be it. I wish I am that. Okay, so be it. We're trying a life after life after life. Eventually, we come to the conclusion, I can never be happy. I'm not Krishna. Who facilitating that? Again, is done by Balaram. Balaram is facilitating the living entities, the conditional living entities, such a way that they will understand one day, I'm not Krishna. The same Balaram is also facilitating them if they want to serve Krishna, either in the material world or spiritual world. It is also done by Balaram. In other words, there is nothing beyond the purview of Balaram. It doesn't exist. Everything, what you see, what you don't see, what we perceive, what we don't perceive, everything is Balaram. Krishna is always enjoying. You are all with me so far? So, that Balaram, because of, there is one more, my favorite topic, which I wanted to say, few technical words. Whatever I said, there is a Sanskrit names are there. I'll just quickly in 2 minutes I'll explain what is that, because you understand what the reason I'm just saying is to establish the greatness of Balaram. The same Balaram is Nityananda Mahaprabhu. To understand, to want to serve somebody, if that person is great, you have to understand how great that person. When that person is so great, when he's taking the role of Nityananda Mahaprabhu, there's no level than that under. He went to that extent. So we can understand how. Usually that is not the nature of Balaram. Balaram is very angry, very straightforward. But when he became Nityananda Mahaprabhu, he changed his paradigm entirely, 360 degrees. So to understand that, Krishna, as I said, is called Swayam Prakasha. He is Swayam Prakasha. That means he is a supreme personality of Godhead. All he does is enjoy. So he becomes Prabhava Prakasha. That means he himself comes as it is. How? He expands many Krishna forms when he is dancing with the gopis. Right? And then sometimes he comes directly to the material world for doing Leela in the material world. So that's all Krishna directly as he comes. Rest of the things is done by Balaram. Whatever I'm going to say from now is everything is done by Balaram. So Krishna becomes Balaram. So Balaram is actually called Vaibhava Prakasha. It's opulent. It's a Vaibhava Prakasha. So now this Vaibhava Prakasha has two aspects. Which is, one is Vilasa, second is Swamsa. Vilasa, I already explained, Balaram expands into first Chaturviha and second Chaturviha and Narayan and then Mahavishnu. So all this expansion is done in spiritual world. In the spiritual world, Balaram expansions is called Vilasa. The second, Swamsa, is actually Balaram's expansions in material world. For the purpose of to encourage the living entity going back to spiritual world. Because when we fall down, we have to go back. He facilitates how everybody is in different stages. Everybody is attracted, right? So now, some are attracted to Leela avatars, like Narasimha, Kurma, Varaha. They are all coming from the expansions of Balaram. Next is Purusha avatars. I just mentioned Purusha avatars is Garbhodakshaya Mahavishnu, Garbhodakshaya Mahavishnu, and then Chirodakshaya Mahavishnu, which is actually expansions of the second Chaturviha in the material world. They are expansions of Balaram. The next is Gunavataras, mode of goodness, mode of passion, mode of ignorance, Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva. They are expansions of Balaram. Next is Sakta Avesha Avataras. They are actually nothing but Narada, even we have been considered as Prabhupada, Brahma, Prithu Maharaj, and then Parashuram, they are actually called Shakta Avesha Avataras. there also is a secondary sector of avatars, Indra, Agni, Brihaspati, Meru. They are also empowered living entities like Balaram. For because he made them as in charge to maintain his entire cosmic manifestation. So next is Manmatha avataras. As there is 14 Manus, they are all expansions of Balaram. The last is Yuga avataras. Every Yuga, Satya Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, Treta Yuga, Kali Yuga, there is a different avataras. So just imagine what is the role of Balaram, how great he is. Right? Now same Balaram is coming as Nityananda Mahaprabhu. So far you are with me? It's a little technical, just to understand before getting the past tense, how great Balaram is. Prabhu.
Balaram's manifestation in the material world, is that like Krishna and Balaram Leela, that Balaram?
Balaram is not manifested into Nityananda Mahaprabhu. Balaram is non-different than Nityananda. They both are same. Same personality. You understand?
Yes.
But you put...
I'm asking a different question.
Okay.
Sorry. You mentioned about Balaram's manifestations in the material world. Does that mean like when Krishna and Balaram come to Earth 5,000 years ago in Vrindavan?
So it's a beautiful question. Sometimes yes, sometimes no.
Oh.
So Krishna sometimes comes to the one of the agency from Kshirodaksaya Mahavishnu. Like when Krishna was born, he didn't born as a two-formed, as Shyamsundara form to Yashoda. He was formed as a four-armed Narayana form.
Yeah.
He's nothing but Kshirodaksaya Mahavishnu. But eventually, based on the parents' prayers, he manifested back to Krishna. Same thing with Balaram Lakshman. So what happens is, this agency is set by Balaram, Krishna also follows. Sometimes he comes as it is, sometimes he comes through the agency.
Thank you.
That answers your question? Yeah. The technical things are done. Now we understand how great is he. Now the same great personality, Balaram, is appeared as Nityananda Mahaprabhu. So, 1474 is the year, and the Radha Desh, also called Ekachakra Dham. So that is a place where Pandavas lived in their exile. Is also where there has a different name before. When Krishna was fighting with in battlefield of Kurukshetra, so Bhishma wants him to make fight. So eventually he picked a wheel and he ran towards Bhishma to kill, right? So eventually Arjuna called him, don't kill him. So he threw the wheel. That wheel actually is one chakra, fallen chakra. That's how the name came. Eka chakra. So the name. There's a history behind. So he decided to appear in the pure devotees called Hadaya Pandit and Padmavati. So pure devotees. They're eternal devotees. So he was born as the eldest son. I think they have eventually six sons, but this is the first one. So ever since he was born, there was a prophecy from his ancestors in that village. One day, the Balaram, the supreme personality of Godhead, will appear in Ekachakra. It has been, as the prophecy was actually explained, to his successors and all the people down. But everybody no one knows when it's going to come. The prophecy was there. The finally Nityananda Mahaprabhu appeared. But no one knows he's Balaram. Because why? He wants to maintain that the confidentiality of his pastime. So as he growing up, he was doing so many pastimes. Amazing pastimes. The pastimes of Krishna, pastimes of Balaram, the pastimes of Lakshmi. Whenever he does it, he absorbs in that pastimes. There's no time to explain many, but I'll just take one example. So one time they were doing the pastime with all the friends of Ravana trying to kill Lakshman. So Ravana threw the javelin, right? Eventually pierced the Lakshman's body in the Ramayana. And then Ravana is actually being played by another friend, and everybody has a different role. And he told, Nityananda Mahaprabhu told, he's also been called Nitya. So the person who's playing Ravana role, he gave a lotus flower. So you threw that and then to my heart, then I'll fall dead. So he did it, touched his heart, he fell down. and he stopped breathing. He was really dead. Everybody thought the prayer is over, now he's about to get up, and he's not getting up. Nitya, what's happening? Where is Nitya? He's already gone. And then the pulse, the body, it became a cold, and no movement at all. They're all scared and start calling everybody. Parents start coming. They shake, they jump, they're like, you know, doing everything, anything. He's not coming back. They started crying. What's happened to Nitya? He's a soul of entire village. Mother, father, they cannot think even a minute separation from him. Not only the people, in the birds, the trees, everything's looking for him. He's so beautiful. His personality, enchanting personality, the words, whatever he does is everybody is so attracted to him. But whole village is crying. And then no one knows what to do. And all of a sudden one little boy thinks, hey, I remember now. He told me, I'm a Hanuman. I supposed to go to Ganda Madhava Parvata and I supposed to bring the medicine. I forgot because he was crying. I totally forgot. No, let me go. And he ran to the side. He got something. Hey, here, Hanuman, I came here. And then now I got the medicine. The medicine, he brought it to right close to the Nityananda Mahaprabhu's nose. He showed it. He got it. That is absorption. We may be laughing, but if you see Prabhupada, who is representing, he is at the same mood, Nityananda Mahaprabhu. Why? Absorbed. Absorption is so powerful in Pratap Bhakti. Whatever you do, when you're chanting, only chant. When you eat prasadam, just eat prasadam. Nothing else. Whatever you do, then absorption is very, very important. That's what he's trying to teach in everything. So he's so absorbed. He was actually enacting the pastime. And everybody's saying, how do you know all these pastimes? Because they're my pastimes. Because nobody could not understand, he's Balaram. Your pastimes? You just born. No one understand. So like the days are passing by, weeks are passing by, years are passing by. 12 years passed. One day, Nityananda Mahaprabhu was sitting under a tree. And he was in trance. He just roared. He just roared like a lion, entire world shook. No one knows, but except Nitya. You know why? Chaitanya Prabhu, Mahaprabhu was born. Now you know the purpose of him coming, my master is arrived. But now, how do I go? These people love me so much. My mother, my father, my brothers, my friends, everybody. So now he has to enact a pastime. So inspire a sadhu who came right after that. Next day, the sadhu came to that village. He directly went to the Hadaya Pandit's house. And Hadaya Pandit Prabhu received him, gave the wonderful food. And then they were talking entire Krishna Katha whole night. Hadaya Pandit and then Padmavati and then sadhu. And then at the end, he has a responsible to Grihastha. So what can I do for you? Please, you're so happy by looking at the sadhu. And then I want to offer something. He said, are you sure? Yes, whatever you want, I'll give you. I'm a sannyasi, I'm traveling length and breadth of the India for pilgrimage. I need an assistant. There is no assistant better than your son Nityananda. I want him. As soon as I heard, he fell dead, as if he's dead. His heart broke. Finally he got up. He said, I know I have to keep up my word, but I cannot because you're asking my own life. You can take me. No, I need him. You already gave the word. It's like a pastimes of Dasarath Maharaj. But he went and consulted his wife. She also unconsciously fell off. And then she got up. And then they consoled each other. We have to do what to do. And then do whatever you say. And then eventually they said, okay, next day morning. And Nitya is ready for that. As soon as mother, father said, Nitya, we have to go. He was painfully saying, Nitya is ready with the bag and he just stopped walking. That made it more painful. So detached. He didn't even look back. His father is looking. Maybe he turns back. Maybe he changes his mind. He didn't even look back. One of the opulent of Supreme Personality of Godhead is a renunciation. He just walked out as if nothing. We are attached to our services at the same time. Objective of the service to please Krishna. When it is necessary, it's very, I'm sitting here and talking, but it's not that easy. When the test comes, and the Balaram is one of the best QA master. QA, in IT we say QA, the quality assurance, quality control. he makes sure whatever a speaker says, it will come. Myself, I'm only victim of my own words many times. Sitting here, you can say, when it comes, my God. Why not say it?
You will feel like, why did I say that?
Yeah. You feel, why did you say? But without saying it, it's also, he tricks us. Preaching is the essence. We want to preach, but what to preach? We have to say, when you say it, come back to us. When you don't preach, there is no purification. Right? So it's very tricky. Krishna, Balaram is very tricky. Suddenly he just walked away. And then anyway, from there he started. But the sadhu, he has a tender heart. And he looked at mother and he said, okay, I have something. He reached his bag and opened the bag and he found a deity of Krishna. It's called Muridhar. And he gave it to him. Gave it to her. And then when our next 3 months, they did not eat, they did not drink. All they was crying. In the meantime, the villagers came to know about that. They all came. And they heard about it. They went in all the directions to find out where is Nitya. He said, don't worry, we will send our son. Or we will go. We will bring the Nitya back. They searched everywhere, they could not find. Then eventually, so everybody left. In 4 months, father and mother left the body. But why does Krishna does this? Why does Balaram does it? Does anybody know? Is he a sadist? He doesn't want our pain. Yes.
You said does anybody know why he does it?
Yeah, why?
Because when the separation, because it's so much, it's like the more you're separated from that person, the more you love him.
Yeah, but it's very painful, right? So, ultimately, we are here not to construct the temples, not to preach, not to make the disciples, not to do so many other things. There's only one reason we come here. Not even service. To change our heart. The service is the means we change the heart. The chanting is the means to we can change our heart. Association, preaching, whatever, they are the means. So that there is a change in the heart. But whatever we do, if it is not changing in the heart, there's something wrong. The purpose of we here is only one reason. To transform our consciousness. Krishna knows exactly when to do, when to switch, how fast, how slow, the pace. He's perfectly orchestrating our way back to Godhead. Sometimes very painful, sometimes very pleasure, sometimes we like to do, sometimes very hard to do, no matter what happens. Because why? The klesha, this klesha, bhava tavagni, it's very difficult. But intensity of the separation, intensity of whatever we do, that is the key. Whatever we do, the intensity in which we put, that intensity, like you know, they're remembering Krishna in a separation, the intensified mood of separation, Krishna is so powerful, it burns entire anarthas. The lifetimes and lifetimes, lifetimes, whatever we had supposed to take, they will be burnt in that separation. Everything is good, fair weather devotee, something good, I'm good. Sunshine devotee, something good, I'm there. Something goes wrong, that's where Prabhu, I'm with you. That is Mahaprabhu. He is Mahaprabhu, right? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Mahaprabhu. To show the world, he just walked away. Anyway, so next 20 years, he traveled with sannyasi. No one knows where the sannyasi gone after that. So he traveled length and breadth, all the places, Ayodhya, Mathura, Vrindavan. South India, which is Rameshwaram, Kedarnath, Badrinath, Rishikesh, all the places. So during these places, he also met a spiritual master. Who's spiritual master?
Madhavendra
Puri. But he also met another person who is actually considered, he also took Diksha. There's actually, he has two spiritual masters. One is Lakshmi Thita, who is actually in the Madhva Sampradaya. Because he's a disciple, he's a devotee of Balaram. So Balaram appeared in his dream. He said, "There's somebody comes tomorrow, give him initiation." He said, "Okay." Then Nityananda came. Okay. He said, "What should I do?" He said, "Give this mantra to me." He gave it back. And then we had a dream next time. So Nityananda transformed to Balaram. As soon as he heard, my God, on my entire life I'm looking for, he was attracted to Balaram. So then he never spoke a word, he never met anybody, he just went into Nijan Bhajan, eventually left. Because that's what is needed. Eventually he met Madhavendra Puri, and then eventually he went back to Vrindavan. He's waiting there. There's a place in Vrindavan, it's called, what is that? There is a place called Vrindavan where, do you anybody know? It's Rasasthal. Rasasthal, that's where he was waiting there. Well, he's waiting because he doesn't want to start his mission. So in the meantime, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is doing his Mahaprakash Leela, he's started chanting, but it was only closed circle. It's not been open to public yet. So one day he was telling Advaita Acharyas and Haridas Thakur, Shivas Thakur, you are sitting there, this one great personality is going to come. And then who is the great personality? Who's already here, go and search for him, you will see. They went and searched all the breathing gods, all the Brahmin houses, all the streets, but they could not find him. They searched for 9 hours. Who is Advaita Acharya? Who is Haridas Thakur, Brahma? Who is Srivas Thakur? They could not even find. So I said, okay, follow me. So in other words, he's saying that Guru cannot be found without Krishna's mercy. And Guru will take us back to Krishna. Everything, there is a reason for it, what we can learn. Even Mahavishnu, which is Advaita Acharya, even Narada, is a Guru. Sir, yadyat yatrite sesta tattat evatro jena sayat pramanam krute lokastat anuvartate. So whatever Krishna does, he also comes and follows. To set an example, so the common people also follow. So now they all reach Nandana Acharya house. So there Nityananda Mahaprabhu sitting in a trance. As soon as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, that if you read the Chaitanya Charitamrita, amazing that union. They saw each other. Nityananda Mahaprabhu was stunned. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was stunned. It's not like, it's the same personality. But how? But they're not faking it. It's not acting it. They're real. And then everyone's looking at each other. They embrace each other, fall unconscious. And then Nityananda Mahaprabhu fall unconscious on Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's lap. And Gadadhar, he already told who is that, he's Balaram to everybody. And Gadadhar Pandita looking, here you see. Ananta Sheshu all this time holding. Now Ananta Sheshu is sitting on the lap of. As soon as he heard, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu felt his embrace, he got up. Because why? He's supposed to serve. You don't want to take service, even unconsciously, even unconsciousness, even in ecstasy. But ecstasy, go to hell, doesn't matter. But if that is not if that is impacting my service attitude, what is the use of that? That everything we can learn. Then eventually, I said, now you are here. So tomorrow is Gaura Purnima. So let's do celebration. So where we should do? He asked him where we should do. Then Nityananda Mahaprabhu looked at each other. In the meantime, what happens when he was unconscious, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told Srivas Thakur, sing one song, sing a particular verse from Srimad Bhagavatam about the Balaram, especially in ground, so how he taking the cows in Vrindavan. So Nityananda Mahaprabhu saw Srivas Thakur sang that song. So he said, let's do this program at his house. That is the compassion of Guru, who has service attitude, who has done something, how he reciprocates, right? So eventually, long story short, and that's where the Mahaprakash Leela happened. So, I only have a few minutes, sorry, I wish more time. So Mahaprakash Leela happened, so that's it now, that's where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu showed his first time, the Shadbhut Chaitanya form, 6 arms. So then he said, okay, now, he told Nityananda Mahaprabhu and Haridas Thakur, so go and start preaching. Whomever you see, say that. Krishna is your father, Krishna is your mother, Krishna is your well-wisher, Krishna. Chant the names of Krishna, associate devotees, serve Krishna, remember Krishna and share with others. That's what they were doing it. While they're doing it, very quickly I'll just want to touch base with Jagai Malai Pastor. So they came across these two wonderful personalities, humongous personalities, you know the story. I just want to make it shorter. So Nityananda Mahaprabhu wanted to see, because wherever they're doing, people are not taking serious. Haridas Thakur, Nityananda, whatever the people are not taking serious, he thought about it. if I make these people devotees, if these people become devotees, entire world will change. Because why? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu always preached to elite group. Nityananda Mahaprabhu, and he left to the most fallen, to Nityananda Mahaprabhu, common people. So we all know the story, like, you know, how he saved those two people. Eventually Madai is trying to hit Nityananda Mahaprabhu, and he was bleeding. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, he was about to kill them. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, no, don't kill them. Actually Jagai tried to save me. As soon as he know how many bad things have done it, but as soon as he heard one good thing, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took it. That without even asking him, Chakra went back. Because he knows what's going to happen. And you saved my Nitya. So then he embraced Jagai. And then eventually Madhya said, when you save him, whatever he did, I also did it. Whatever he should, I should supposed to receive too. Please save me. He said, I can save you, but I cannot save you because they all hurt me, but you hurt my devotee, my brother. So if he chose to save you, then I will. So then he fell at his feet, and then he said, okay. And then long story short, and then they were become devotees. And next day, they were all sitting with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They were sitting there, and they were all chanting. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told them, never ever think those who are here, the past of Jagat Madai. I already took their karma and the sins, and he showed his form, blackish form, entirely blackish. Don't even think, they are now devotees, don't even think about their past anymore. He said, but what's going to happen to this black, because those who offend the devotees, this the sin, the black body, will enter into their body. Whoever offend the devotees, knowingly or unknowingly, but at least they don't ask forgiveness. So they like to suffer the Jagai Madai, the sins. So in spite of that, Madai was still unhappy. He went and followed Nityananda Mahaprabhu's feet. He says, I did so much of offenses, please save me. No, you already saved. No. I'm very bad. So I hit you. And I tried to hit you second time. He said, Hare Baba, forget it. I gave you forgiveness. What else I can do? No. Still I'm suffering. Okay, do one thing. Why don't you do something? Go and do something and serve all the people. Because I was so in drunken state, I didn't even know who offended. So whoever comes to the bathing ghat, you create a bathing ghat and then wash their feet and then serve them. That's what Madhya was doing for a long time. And then some of the people who were offended, they used to come and hit with stones with its mother. And without any morals, without any complaints, pick those stones and again taking them back to them. He says, I deserve worse than this. Please hit me again. That's what I was saying. The purpose of us is only one, to change the heart. That only happens when you have the mercy of Nityananda Mahaprabhu. So there's no end what we can talk. There's so much. But I just want to end here. Nityananda Mahaprabhu is not different than Balaram. We understand who is he, what is the purpose, what is the tattva, and we also understand the purpose of that. So eventually Nityananda Mahaprabhu went back at the spiritual world by merging into the Bankim Raj and Radharani's deity in Ek Chakra. Okay. He visited one more time. So having said that, I really ran. In fact, I really flew my class, whatever I wanted to say. So if anybody has any comments, questions, the same Balaram, without even second thought, he cut the nose and ears of Supurnaka. Without a second thought, as soon as the Pandavas or Kauravas offended Krishna in the marriage of Samba, he dragged entire Hastinapur into Ganges. Without even a second thought, when he saw Romaharshan Sutta was sitting in a Vyasasan, and he says, you have the knowledge, but you have no integrity. You have no character, that's what the word you said. He just killed him without even a second thought. The same Balaram, keeping the same Kushagrash between his teeth, is falling at everybody. Please chant names of Krishna. Please chant names of Gauda. Krishna is your father, Krishna is your mother, Krishna is your guru, Krishna is your well-wisher. Think about Krishna, remember Krishna, serve the devotees, and share with others. That was a message. So just imagine to get empowered from Nityananda Mahaprabhu. Of course, what is my qualification? I always think it's the nine wonders, always the tenth wonder is me talking about Krishna. You know, I'm not sitting in glasses and what did I do? Knowingly, I didn't do any good thing in my entire life. But somehow, even though I'm the worst, I always got the best. Best devotees association. An opportunity to serve, opportunity to associate. Nityananda Prabhu ki! So let's end the class here. Sri Sri Jagadguru, Adi Guru, Parama Karuna. Sri Nityananda Mahaprabhu ki
jai.
Nityananda Mahaprabhu ki
jai.
Nityananda Mahaprabhu appearance day ki
jai.
Srila Prabhupada ki
jai.
Hare
Krishna. Krishna Prabhu Nityananda Srila Taita Tadadha Srila Chati Gaur.